game show.
Are you ready? Go! Here are the rules.
No! Game show.
May we have our next contestant, please? You ready? Go, 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 go! Here's how we play the game.
Is the answer.
Do you quit or do you go on?
Good luck. Game show.
This is it for the game. Game.
Time is up.
You're right.
You stole the game.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, here is your host for the start of our show, the always unpredictable
Alex.
Here's
how we play the game. The goal is to get a milkshake on the board.
I noticed that you can do it.
But anyway, if
you goof,
you make mistakes occasionally.
You do a lot.
Okay.
You get two chances. The one who scores the most,
they have to crawl all the way in the paper bag. But I'm going to try and clear that up as we go along. Okay.
Hold your discussions until I call them.
Yo!
If you're ready, if they're ready to go, we're ready to go.
Only one of you will survive this match.
No fooling around here, okay?
Okay.
Okay.
Let's win some money. All right, let's get on with it.
Finally, you all set to play?
All right, here we go with round number one.
100 people surveyed. Top five answers on the board.
What was the name of the castaway's boat in Gilligan's Island?
Current British Prime Minister.
Is your grandfather somebody famous?
Now we've got a call for an answer. There are about 40,000 muscles and tendons in this part of an elephant's body.
Do you touch what you service with your hands?
Yes.
All right, now ready to use your signals to interrupt.
Hey, I would like a D, as in dog.
A famous Midwestern city is known as the rubber capital of the United States.
Ladies, on what feature of your anatomy has your husband lavished the most praise?
Back over here, pick up a saucer, put it on top of the cup. Back over there, pick up the last cup and put it on top of the saucer.
What is it in your life that makes you feel the most pressure?
Will the Brooklyn Dodgers have anything to do with it?
I don't think so.
No. Hitter.
Slugger.
Yes!
What national parents group with a name that shows how angry Dan?
Mad Motor Vehicle Driver.
That's right. Which one belongs to a thirsty athlete? The right or the left? Please be sure it is in the form of a question.
Could you repeat the question?
What's the question? What is the question?
Well, can a 20-year-old girl find happiness with a 60-year-old man? If you answer this one correctly, you will win the game.
Not bad.
No.
No.
Time is up, Cynthia. That means that Dorothy.
What's the question? Jimmy Hendrix.
Oh, I'm sorry. Time is up.
Too much time. Greg.
I guess I'll say watermelon.
Watermelon. See, since your favorite fruit, apple.
I never eat apples. What's wrong with you?
Let's go over the bonus board. Make a whole bunch of money, okay?
You want the green stuff.
Last question.
So a lot of money at stake. Really anybody's game at this point.
Okay, this is the big one now.
For $5,000, may we see your answer?
So, I'm with you all the way.
Survey says...
Is the answer Casablanca?
Yeah!
You got it! You got it!
A thief!
Yeah!
And a
What? What's the question?
Chuck thinks he knows the answer.
The toilet?
You're right.
Nobody goes away empty-handed.
Our grand prize winner is today. There's $8,000.
I'm Peter Tamarkin, I think. Welcome to Game Show Network, and hello to everyone at the Western Cable Show. Hope you're having a good time out there. What you've been watching was a very special retrospective of the history of game shows. And that's what Game Show Network is all about. The best and the brightest of game shows 24 hours a day. Now, if you're a game show fanatic like I am, what we've got is just what you've been looking for, and a whole lot more. Here are some of the best classic shows we'd be offering to you, the viewer. Shows like Wheel of Fortune, Jeopardy, What's My Line, To Tell the Truth, Password, I've Got a Secret, Match Game, Joker's Wild, Tic-Tac-Toe, Newlywed Game, Dating Game, and Beat the Clock. What did I tell you? Pretty impressive, isn't it? And there's more. You can join me every night for Prime Games from 7 p.m. to 11 p.m. Eastern, where we'll bring you the only live interactive games in town. Interactive games like Decades. This interactive game will test your knowledge of things past and present from the 1910s through the 1990s. And the good news is that everyone watching Game Show Network can play our live interactive games from their own living room. It's just as easy as dialing a phone number. Throughout the day, we'll be instructing you how you can register to become a player. Listen and pay attention to what you must do to get your 8-digit PIN number. Once you got that number, you can play our live interactive games forever. And unlike any other games in town, the call you make to play is a toll-free number. Every call you make is free. And believe you me, you'll want to keep calling as often as you can because the prizes you can win are unreal. And for you early risers who like company with your coffee, tune in and join Steve Day and Laura Chambers on Club AM. They're great from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. Eastern as they deliver interesting TV tidbits and answer your phone calls and faxes all live. And by the way, you can also see Steve and Laura every night from midnight to 4 a.m. Eastern with Late Night Games, offering you the best in night owl entertainment on television. Now, why do people like game shows? Well, probably because in many cases you see people just like yourself having fun. And it's also fun to play along at home and see if you can come up with the answers before the contestants. And celebrities, you say? Well, how can we forget the celebrities? From the panel shows of the 50s to the outrageous shows of the 90s, the stars sometimes become as identifiable as the shows themselves. I mean, who doesn't think of Kitty Carlisle when To Tell the Truth comes to mind? And what would What's My Line be without Arlene Francis? To start us off, we take you back to 1950. Harry Truman was in the White House, Mona Lisa and Goodnight Irene were two of the nation's most popular songs. On January 28th, Milton Berle's Texaco Star Theater and Life of Riley won Emmys as top TV shows. 5 days later, on Thursday, February 2nd, CBS premiered a new panel game show from Mark Goodson, Bill Todman Productions. Viewers tuning in were treated to What's My Line, and the treat continued for the next 17 and a half years. Almost everyone in show business and beyond appeared on the show as a mystery guest, from stars like Charlton Heston and Lucille Ball to athletes such as Mickey Mantle and Arthur Ashe. It seemed everyone wanted to enter and sign in, please. Following the CBS version, What's My Line returned for a 7-year run in syndication starting in 1968. The hosts were Wally Brunner and then Larry Blyden. Now, let's take a trip down memory lane and have a look at What's My Line, originally broadcast on March 8, 1953, with panel Bennett Cerf, Dorothy Kilgallen, Steve Allen, Arlene Francis, and of course, the famous mystery guest. What's My Line can be seen right here on Game Show Network each weekday at 8:30 a.m. and as part of Prime Games at 10:20 p.m. Eastern Time.
And now, What's My Line, brought to you by Stop at Spray Deodorant. Poof, there goes perspiration. Poof Deodorant Body Powder, the body powder you spray. The Nest Shampoo, the new flowing cream shampoo. All in the first truly functional cosmetic containers, far easier to use. All created by Dr. Jules Montagnier, the famous cosmetic chemist. Time now to enjoy What's My Line.
Now, let's meet our award-winning What's My Line panel of well-known personalities whose lines you already know. First, the popular columnist whose voice of Broadway appears in the New York Journal American and papers coast to coast, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
And on my left, the young humorist who has his own television show and is currently in rehearsal with a new Broadway play, The Pink Elephant, Mr. Steve Allen.
Thank you. On my left, one of the lovely ladies of radio and television who tonight, I don't know if it's visible to you folks at home, but she's all spangled with little spangles. It's very lovely. Arlene Spangle, or Arlene Francis.
Thank you, Steve. And on my left, a gentleman who we have missed very much while he's been vacationing in sunny California, and whom we welcome back with a 21-gun salute of affection, Mr. Bennett Cerf.
I see I've been moved south of the border since I left. And in the case of Arlene, it's certainly the prettiest border I ever saw. On my left is the famous news commentator and moderator of this show, and it's my first chance to say in public how good I think he is, Mr. John Charles Daly.
Thank you. Nice to have you back. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to What's My Line, presented by Stop It. Once again tonight, we're going to put our cameras on some people who've come to visit us and brought with them some very interesting and, we hope, unexpected occupations to give the panel some trouble so they'll get some prizes. We'll also have a famous guest challenger before the panel a bit later on. But now to start things rolling, it's time for the experts to meet our first challenger whose job they've got to spot. So would you sign in, please, ma'am? Mary... Mary Flory, is that right? Take it easy. Nothing's going to happen. Everything's going to be fine. Is it Miss or Mrs.?
Miss.
Miss Flory, where are you from?
Glen Line, Pennsylvania.
From Pennsylvania. Well, now, we haven't got anybody from Pennsylvania on the panel, so perhaps you'd like to go down and see what some outlanders look like. Will you walk down in front of the panel for me, please? All right, Miss Mary, you come on over here now, please, and sit down next to me. And on the basis of that chance to meet you briefly and that fine, clear, meticulous handwriting of yours, perhaps they have some ideas. Because this time, we always give the panel one free and wild guess as to what your line may be. We'll begin the free guesses with Miss Kilgallen.
I think she models bridal gowns.
Mr. Allen.
I think she models flower pots.
Miss Francis.
I think she's an egg candler.
Sir.
I think she's going to be a bride herself any day.
Well, that may be true, but that's not the answer we're looking for. We'll let our viewers at home have another look at Miss Mary Flory, and at the same time, we'll tell them what her line is. The panel's got to dig, and Miss Flory, the rules are simplicity itself. Every time you get a no answer from anybody over there on the panel, it costs the panel $5. We'll keep a record of it up here. 10 of these no's. And you have won the game. Miss Flory is salaried with that. Let's begin the general questioning with Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
Do you work for a profit-making organization, Miss Flory?
Yes.
And do you deal in services?
Yes.
Would both men and women be interested in your services?
Yes.
You learn new things. Well,
Would you say that your services applied more to one sex than the other? Is that the female sex?
No.
1 minute and 9 to go, Mr. Pink Elephant. Mr. Allen, excuse me.
Wonder what sex is left. That's the male sex, I take it.
Yes.
I see. Is there a product of any kind connected with what you do?
Yes.
Is it a product that might be found in the home?
Yes.
Is it smaller than a bread box?
Yes.
It is. Is it smaller than a loaf of bread?
Yes.
On a in a two-story home, would it be found on the second floor?
Yes.
Would it be more apt to be found on the second floor than the first? I mean,
No,
I wouldn't think so. 2 down and 8 to go, Miss Benson.
Is this something that a man would ever, that a woman might buy for a man?
Yes.
Would it be in the category of gifts at Christmas time or birthday time?
Yes.
Is it anything that a man might put on?
No.
Well, that's 3 down and 7 to go, Mr. Smith.
Miss Flory, is this consumable?
It is consumed in the use, yes.
In other words, it has to be replaced from time to time because it is either eaten or drunk or used up in one way or another. Is that right?
Yes.
Well, now, would this be used up by being put inside the mouth?
Yes.
In part, yes. Hmm?
In part.
Only part of it would be put into the mouth?
You throw away the peel.
But all we're trying to convey, we don't want to confuse you, is that you suggested that, you might put everything in the mouth at once. Well, I
you
have
say
seen...
Only part. Well, yeah. After all this is over, Miss Flory, what I gather from this, am I correct in saying that this would not aid your digestion in any particular way?
It would not aid your digestion. There is, I believe, the premise that actually it does aid digestion. We might, you and I, have a quarrel about this later, but two, no. 1 out of 6 to go, Miss Kildallan.
Well, when this thing is in the gentleman's mouth, does part of it show at any time?
Yes.
He's no gentleman if it does.
Is this anything that has ever grown at any time, even in part?
Yes.
Has it ever been in leafy form?
Yes.
Is it any form of tobacco?
Yes.
Well, is it cigar?
Yes.
Yes. Bob tobacco. Now, wait a minute. Now we have identified the product as cigars, but what relation does Miss Flory have to the cigar?
She wraps them, or, you know, that thing they do with cigars.
Puts one layer on top of another.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm afraid we'll have to give it. Actually, make cigars is the right answer. Very good, panel. Well, Miss Flory, you have done reasonably well with the prize department, but more, we hope that you've had a good time. It's been nice to have you with us, and what's my line? Thanks very much.
John, Mr. Dalen, about this digestion, it may help the man's digestion, but I don't think wives' digestion will help by it.
No.
That's true. I should have given you a qualified.
Qualified.
All right, now let's see what you can do with another challenger. You've all ready signed in. That is Ruth Cooper. Is that right? Will you come over here? Miss or Mrs.? Mrs. Cooper. And where are you from, Mrs. Cooper?
Center of the world, Mercerville, New Jersey.
The center of the world, Mercerville, New Jersey. Wait till I hear about this up in Boston. There's going to be some trouble. Well, now, would you be good enough to walk down there in front of the panel? They would like to know you a bit better.
Is that where the Mercer School is, Miss?
Mercerville.
Mercerville
School.
Well, Mercer me.
Mercerville Heavens.
Thank you.
All right, Mrs. Cooper, will you come over here now, please, and sit down next to me? And what we do at this point, because you've had a chance to meet the panel and they've had a chance to meet you, is to give them one free guess as to what your line may be, and we'll begin those free guesses, as usual, with Miss Kilgall.
I think Mrs. Cooper raises porkers.
Raises porkers? Mr. Allen.
I think she lowers porkers.
Miss Preston.
I think she's a wardrobe mistress.
Mr. Sir.
I think she works in a boys' school.
No, I'm afraid nobody has it. We'll let our viewers at home have a further look at Mrs. Cooper. At the same time, they will learn what her line is. Miss Cooper, I think you know what the rules are. Every time we get a no answer on the penny, it costs them $5. We keep the record as always, right up here. But 10 of these no's, and you have won the game. This is the last usual bit of help. Mrs. Cooper is self-employed. With that, let's begin the general questioning with Steve Allen.
Thanks a lot. Boy, from that reaction, she must pitch for the Dodgers or something. Mrs. Cooper, in the course of your work, do you come into contact with a product of any kind?
Yeah.
I think these people know something. Is it a product that might be encountered in the home?
Yes.
Is there anything funny about that? Could I possibly hold it in my hand?
Yes.
Is it something that a housewife might come into contact with?
Yes.
Could she conceivably come into contact with it at mealtime?
Yes.
Well, let me get right to the point. Is it edible?
Yes.
I gather from the reaction of the audience that this is something that would not ordinarily be served as the main course.
Yeah, I will have to say, Steve, you're right. This is not something that would be... Yes, it would not be served as the main course, no.
In fact, the reaction was so vigorous, I would suppose that there are some people who would not even like to eat this at all.
Yeah, well, you know, I mean, there's... issue of personal choice in almost every decision any of us takes. There'd be some people who wouldn't like to eat this.
Let me think, what is edible that I don't like? outside of food. Could you possibly put this on a piece of rye bread?
The question, could you put it on a piece of rye bread?
Yes.
I'm going to have a conference. Conference, and we have decided, since the question phrase is, could you put this on a piece of rye bread, that in all fairness to you, we should say, yes, you could put it on.
Oh, I think I'm on the wrong track altogether. Might as well clear it up, though. Is this the kind of a thing that people might like to eat, say, on crackers in bed, that sort of thing?
One down and nine to go, Miss Francis.
Would you be able to purchase this in a store?
No.
2 down and 8 to go, Mr. Sir.
Mrs. Cooper, is this a liquid by any chance?
Could be.
Could be.
Could be.
Does it have any medical properties?
No, I'm afraid it hasn't got any medical properties. 3 down and 7 to go, Mr. Kilgallen.
Mrs. Cooper, is this by any chance something that unless you were terribly eccentric, you would never serve at dinner?
Yes, it is something that you would not serve at dinner.
Would not serve at dinner.
Yes, you would not serve it at dinner, no.
But you have said that housewives would come in contact with it and Steve would have come in contact with it. Do you think I might have come in contact with it? Does this have a variety of aspects? Would you have it around the house as a result of something else that happened? Yes.
Would you have it around the house as a result of something else that had happened?
Yeah. Would you have it around the house as a result of eating meals?
Yes.
Is it something like garbage?
Yeah. All right.
And that's why Steve wouldn't put it on piece of fried bread.
That's why we were very careful to say, Steve said, could you put it on rye bread? Well, you could put it on rye bread. I don't know if you want to. But now we've identified the product as garbage, but what does Mrs. Cooper have to do with saying?
Is she by any chance a collector?
I'm afraid we'd have to buy that because Mrs. Cooper actually drives a garbage truck, which I imagine would be...
She has a collector to drive.
Well, Mrs. Cooper, let's see. You have won $15. You have our thanks for being our guest. Thanks very much. Well, very good, panel. Now, in just a moment, ladies and gentlemen, we'll introduce our mystery guest. But first, word of an interesting new product.
Racing.
yourself for the action movie that's nothing less than brilliant. The Professional is an absolute knockout. Explosive and thrilling.
I'm dying to meet him.
A riveting, nail-biting film. It makes speed look like a slow ride to Grandma's house. From internationally acclaimed action director Luc Besson, The Professional, rated R, at theaters now.
Game shows, everyone's favorite television.
I love the old celebrity, Gary Cooper.
Do you sit tall in the saddle?
I would say a little crooked.
Dean Martin.
Jerry Lewis. Hey, lady, places.
Don't let me get who we are now.
I like Russell Moore.
Are you an old Buick?
Lisa the Ball.
Wow.
Are you a dazzling redhead?
All of them. I love them all.
Tune in to watch, play, and win on the all-new Game Show Network.
Now we come to the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery celebrity. My friends on the panel would recognize our guest right away, so we've provided them with blindfolds. Are the blindfolds all in place, panel?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Good. Will you come in, mystery challenger, and sign in, please? Panel, as you know, in the case of our mystery guest, we always dispense with preliminaries, get right down to the general questioning, which we will begin with Arlene Francis.
Would you be considered an entertainer?
Yes.
Would you be considered a leading man?
Thanks.
Pat? Are you in pictures?
You mean the moving pictures?
Well, I knew he wasn't hanging in the Louvre.
We would like here, because there is a specific pointed issue, to ask
have
you to repeat the question.
All right, John. Have you been in motion pictures?
Yes.
Well, since there is some concern about the picture angle, do you also appear in television?
Yes.
Would you be considered a serious actor?
No.
Mind to go, Mr. Sir.
Might I ask, do you ever use any props in your act?
Yes.
Would this prop be, by any chance, alive?
No.
That's two down and eight to go, Miss Kilgallen.
You are not a serious actor, has that been established?
That's right, yes.
Well, are you then a funny actor?
Wait.
Are you a comedian?
I'll answer it for him, Miss Dorothy. A very funny actor.
Do you have your own television show, one on which you star regularly, I mean?
Yes.
You're not just a floating guest artist.
I didn't quite get that, Dorothy.
Do you
this
work...
This man is firmly anchored.
Do you work with other people in your act, either partners or straight men?
Yes.
Do you work with a woman in your act?
Sometimes.
Do you also work with a straight man at times?
Yes.
Do you all work together sometimes?
Yes.
are you an excellent dialectician?
No.
That makes it 3-7 to go. That is a subjective judgment. Mr. Allen?
Do you do impersonations?
Yes.
Sounds like Gable, huh?
Martin or Clark?
Did you ever have your own radio program?
Yes, baby.
All right, one. Are you over 40?
No.
That's 4-6 to go, Miss Francis.
Would you be considered a juvenile?
No.
What is this?
No.
I didn't say delinquent. I said juvenile.
Yeah. A delinquent, you might have gotten a different answer. $5 to go, Mr. Smith.
Have you ever done any ventriloquism?
No.
$6.40 to go, Miss Kilgallen.
I still think you're a good dialectician, but I'll skip that. Do you ever make odd noises and impersonate inanimate objects?
No.
Make odd noises and impersonate inanimate objects. What, mm-hmm. what do you have? Would you mind if
well,
we...
Well, like, do imitations of things like pinball machines.
No.
No pinball machine, hey.
Are you, on the heavy side?
Yes.
That's too bad. You see, I had a thin fellow in mind. Do you work for a rival network?
No.
Hey, John, wait a minute. That's right. Don't. Hey, John, who to go, Miss Francis?
You're on the lighter side of the, and you're heavy. You're a comedian and you're a heavy comedian. Do you appear on a regular television show once a week?
Yes.
Do you sort of not care what happens to you on this show? I mean, do they throw you around and slide down alleys and carry on like mad and wear funny clothes?
Yes.
You are an American.
Yes.
Are you Jimmy Gleason?
No.
Jack Gleason?
Jack Gleason, that's right. The slickest French accent we've heard in a long, long time.
It was very, very pleasant being on the show.
Well, I must say it was a great pleasure having you with us.
Thank you, Jack.
Honor us with your presence. Would you say bye-bye to the panel? It's nice to see you, Jack.
You're very
You're watching Game Show Network, your 24-hour game show source. If you have any comments, an interesting game show story, or appeared on one of our shows, drop us a line at Game Show Network, 10202 West Washington Boulevard, Culver City, California, 90232. You may hear your letter read weekdays on Club AM, 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. Eastern, or Prime Game, 7 to 11 p.m. Eastern. So watch Game Show Network, the only network that lets you play along.
Now let's see what we can do with another challenger. Would you sign in, please, sir? Jack? Jack Joyce. Is that right, sir? Tell us first of all where you're from.
Ventura County, California.
Ventura County, California. Well, Mr. Surf just came from Ventura County, California. Time is getting a little bit short, so will you just walk down in front of the panel, turn right around and walk back again? Right back here, Mr. Joyce, if you will, and sit down next to me. And the panel has had a chance to get a quick look at you. At this point, we always give them one free guess as to what your line may be. And we'll begin the free guesses with Miss Kilgallen.
I think he makes golf tees.
Mr. Allen.
I think he's one of Jackie Gleason's riders.
Miss Francis.
I think he's an outrider at the racetrack.
Mr. Sir.
I think Mr. Joyce runs one of those cable cars on Powell Street in San Francisco.
No, I'm afraid not. We'll let our viewers at home have a further look at Mr. Joyce, and at the same time, we'll tell them what his line is. Now that everything's all ready here, we've got the scoreboard set. Mr. Joyce, I think you know the rules. Each no answer, $5. 10 no's, you win the game. We keep the score up here. Mr. Joyce is salaried with that. Let's begin the general questioning with Bennett, sir.
Joyce, is there a product involved in what you do?
No.
That's one down and nine to go. Miss Kilgallen.
You deal in services, then?
Yes.
Do you deal with both men and women when you're performing your services?
Deal with both men and women when you are performing your services?
Yes.
Are you inclined to come in contact with one sex more than the other, however?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Are these men?
No, I think the question was, are these men? We'd have to say one. Two down and eight to go, Mr. Allen.
Are they by any chance children?
No.
No, that's three down and seven to go, Miss Francis.
Are they by any chance animals?
Yes.
You might come in contact with animals?
Yes, right.
In your work? Are there a variety of animals in your job?
No.
That would make it four down and six to go, Mr. Sitt.
Mr. Joyce, are these animals that are raised in California?
Well, some are raised there. We'd have to answer you in a qualified sense.
I would say then there aren't very many of these animals in California. Is that correct?
Yes, there are not very many animals.
You should be moderator. That was very good.
Have these animals been imported for exhibition rather than for farming of some sort?
Yes.
Would you find them in a zoo?
Yes.
Have you got something to do with a zoo?
No.
No, that's five down and five to go, but Bennett, you opened a lot of doors. Miss Kilgallen.
Are these animals which are ever performing animals?
Yes.
Have they got four legs or hands and feet or whatever you want to call them?
Four legs, yes.
Do they sometimes stand up and walk around like this?
No, wait, you mean stand up on their hind legs and walk around?
Yes.
No, thank you very much. That's $6 and four to go, Mr. Allen.
But they have four legs, is that right?
Uh-huh, four something.
I presume they never have any more than four legs, is that right?
Yes, you are right in presuming they don't have more than four legs.
Do they have fur?
Yes.
Do they ever bite?
Yes.
Why don't you get rid of them?
All right, Steve, one more question. Our time is running out.
Do your animals perform, with you?
Yes.
Are you an animal trainer?
Yes, he is, but that isn't enough. So we'll have to, time has run out, and Mr. Joyce will get the full prize by default. You had the right idea. Actually, he trains camels. You know, the Pollock Brothers Shrine Circus that does so much good for crippled youngsters. Well, he has a trained camel group, and they do wonderful work.
What does he train them to do?
The only one in the world. He trains the camels. Thank you very much, Mr. Joyce, and you get the full prize. Nice to have you again. And now, in just a moment, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to give you a preview look at one of our guests whose line our panel is going to be asked to try and identify on next week.
All right, in a moment, I'm going to tell you how you can register to play Decades. But in the meantime, Mike Wagner's going crazy. He wants to tell you about our eligibility requirements. Mike, speak to me, baby.
No purchase necessary. All entrants must have pre-registered and have a valid PIN number. Winners must sign an affidavit of eligibility. Contests open to all legal residents of the United States 18 years of age and older, except employees and their families of Sony Pictures Entertainment, Game Show Network, and any other person or entity associated with contests. Void were prohibited by law. Subject to all applicable laws and regulations. Taxes, including applicable sales tax, are the sole responsibility of winners, and contestants can win only one prize during a 30-day period. Rules may be subject to change. Odds of winning determined by number of entrants. Prizes may not be substituted or transferred. For complete rules and or a list of prize winners, send a self-addressed stamped envelope to Game Show Network Rules, P.O. Box 4312, Hollywood, California, 90078.
All right, I love you, Mike. I love you. Now, folks, if you want to now play the first and the only live interactive game in the world, this is the place. I'll give you the phone number. It is 800-537-GAME, 800-537-GAME. You want to call that in order to get your 8-digit PIN number. Once you have to have that in order to play, and once you have it, you can play again and again and again. It's 800-537-GAME, touch-tone phones only, 800-537-GAME. And while you're doing that, we're going to go back to the 1953 version of What's My Line with John Daly. Stay with us!
Next week at this same time, our panel of experts will be asked, What's My Line by this man? Would you know what his occupation is? Could you spot his line? Well, for answers to these and a good many other questions, some of them serious and some of them hilarious, be sure and join us again next Sunday night at 10:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, when once again, Stop It invites you to play What's My Line? For other localities, check your local listings for the date and time of our weekly television series. And don't forget, What's My Line on Wednesday night on CBS Radio. Until we see you again then, this is John Daly saying good night, Dorothy.
Good night, Steve.
Good night, Arlene.
Good night, Bennett.
Sure, nice to be back. Good night, John.
And nice to have you back. Good night, and glad to have you with us on What's My Line.
This has been a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production in association with the CBS Television Network.
All right, folks. Registration is fini. That's it. All buttoned up. No more calls, please. You can stop your calling. Don't worry. You can register later tonight to play Decades and tomorrow morning. So just hang in there. And we're going to show you how to play Decades. It's fun. It's fast. It's curious. And it's a lot of great things. Come on back.
Hello, Lifesavers.
Believe it or not, this man's job is saving lives. Call him supportive.
In my line of work, I deal with all kinds of people.
Hello.
None of them are what you might call conventional.
Call him understanding.
This is all I do all day is deal with nuts like you!
Just don't call him for help.
I want to die.
May I put you on hold?
Steve Martin.
You're a marvelous dancer. Thank you.
Mixed Nuts, rated PG-13, at theaters December 21st.
Does everyone love the new Game Show Network?
The emotions, it just took pages.
I always love just watching people spaz out.
It's exciting, it's fun.
I sit in front of the TV, I scream out the answers.
That's right, you're wrong.
I'm addicted to game shows.
Needlepoint is marvelous therapy.
Everybody wants to win.
I love to win.
All right!
Game shows is where it's at.
Tune in to watch, play, and win on the all-new Game Show Network.
Let the games begin!
Next up, Bud Collier takes contestants through wacky stunts for fabulous prizes. Beat the Clock on Game Show Network.
All right, we don't have much time, so let me kind of give you some idea about decades.
It involves photographs, it involves a 30-second clock, and interactive live telephone chatting with me, and great prizes. That's a pretty good package, and I think you'll agree. But before we play decades, let's go back and see Bud Collier in a great show, Beat the Clock.
Everyone's seen the phrases of the Game Show Network.
Mr. Postman, look at me.
I'm with you watching Jeopardy. I've got a secret and it's plain to see. I'm in love with Game Show Network TV. Mr. Postman, my heart skips a beat to tell the truth. I just love to compete. The wheel of fortune is spinning for me. Cause you're right here on Game Show Network TV.
All right, if you are among the two players selected to compete in our live interactive game, Decades, here's how you play it. With 30 seconds on our clock, I'm going to show you photos, and then I'll read a question relating to that photo. Your job? Simple. Supply the decade that answers the question. Now, in our game, decades begin with 0 and end with 9, such as the 70s would be 1970 to 1979. Now, for example, I'll show you this photo. Then I'll ask the question, during what decade did this famous group first sing on the Ed Sullivan Show? On the keypad, these three buttons will light up, the 5, the 6, and the 7 representing the three choices you have as possible answers. Now, if you know the answer, you're going to press the number 6 on your telephone keypad, indicating the 60s as your answer. Your choice is highlighted, your answer is confirmed as being correct, and you're on your way to scoring big on decades. It is just as easy as that. And the player who scores the highest number of points will win a fabulous prize. Tell them about it, Peter. Well, I'll tell you what it is, Peter. It is a Sony 27-inch color television set. Not bad. Don't go away. We'll be back in just a few minutes. You know, Game Show Network will be bringing you free live interactive games such as Decades every single night. And just so you can get an idea of how Decade is played, I'm going to show you what it's like with this simulated version where a winner might receive this prize. Mike?
A Sony 27-inch color TV from Service Merchandise, a gift certificate. Select top-name brands from our catalog or redeem at any of our over 400 stores nationwide from Service Merchandise.
All right, we have two players on the line right now. both ready, willing, and able to play decades. We have player A from anywhere USA, and we've got player B from any place USA. Welcome to you both. Player A, guess what? You get to go first. Player B, guess what? You get to watch what player A does, because you're going to get a chance to better his score when your time comes. Player A, it is now your time. Remember, you can't enter an answer until you see the three lighted buttons on the keypad on your TV screen. All the buttons on the keypad will be locked out except the three lighted possible answer buttons, and your answer will not register unless you press one of those lighted buttons. That's important. All right, now that we understand that, let's put 30 seconds on your clock, Player A. If you're ready, here comes your first photo, and go! During what decade was this superhero first introduced to the public in his own comic book? 20s, 30s, or 40s? Correct, 30s. During what decade were affluent Americans driving this luxurious car? 30s, 40s, or 50s? Correct, 50s. During what decade did this very bright man decline the offer to become the president of Israel? 50s, 60s, or 70s? Incorrect, 50s. During what decade did this popular pinup girl marry a young man with a horn named Harry James? 30s, 40s, or 50s? 40s, correct. During what decade did actor Jimmy Stewart portray this man in the film Spirit of St. Louis? 40s, 50s, or 60s? Incorrect, 50s. During what decade did Martin Landau portray the life of this famous actor in a movie? 70s? Ah, time is up. Time is up. 70s, 80s, or 90s? Correct answer was 90s. You got three correct, Player A, and you were trucking. All right, Player B, you've been very patient. We'll see how well you can do, because you have to answer more than three questions correctly, and you walk off with that Sony television set. All right, Player B, same goes for you. We're going to put 30 seconds on your clock. Here it comes, and if you're ready, here's your first photo, and go! During what decade did this teen heartthrob trade his blue suede shoes for army fatigues? 50s, 60s, or 70s? Incorrect, 50s. During what decade did this president graciously resign his presidency? 60s, 70s, or 80s? Correct, 70s. During what decade did this comedy team first meet up with Frankenstein at the box office? 30s, 40s, or 50s? Correct, 40s. During what decade did this notorious gangster take a ride up the river for tax evasion? 20s, 30s, or 40s? Incorrect, 30s. During what decade was this film playing at your local theater? 30s, 40s? Ah, time is up, and you didn't make it, Player B, but Player A, congratulations. You won yourself a Sony color television set. And Player B, I thank you for being with us. We've got a really nice AT&T gift certificate for you. I hope you had a real nice time playing, and it was nice to have you with us. Player A, a Sony color television set. Congratulations. I think it's great. And guess what? We're going to come back and get all the information from you so we can send you that Sony TV. And we'll come back and play Decades in a little bit. And in the meantime, I want to thank you all for being with us and playing Decades. We'll be back. What a guy, what a night, what a band. Well, that's how Decades is played. And remember, if you don't already have your PIN number, don't forget to call in when it's time to register. Decades is only one of many live interactive games that we'll be playing here on Game Show Network. And all you need is a PIN number to play in all the game shows coming up. Registration times are announced all day long, so stay with us, and we'll give you that toll-free number a little later. Lots of fun and big prizes could be yours just by using your touch-tone phone. Coming up soon is a classic episode of Beat the Clock, starring Bud Collier. I'll see you later.
The moment I clapped eyes on you.
There are loves we'll always remember. Memories time cannot erase. And stories we can never forget. Winona Ryder, Little Women. Rated PG. At theaters everywhere, Christmas Day.
Coming this summer only on home video from Sony Wonder. It's The Jungle King. The tale of a king with some royal problems. And when there's trouble in the jungle, it's up to his kind-hearted brother to show him what it means to be a real leader.
I want you all to be happy.
There's romance, adventure, music and fun the whole family can enjoy again and again.
I go boom, chicky, boom, chicky, boom.
The Jungle King, wherever videos are sold. Now available on home video from Sony Wonder. You're watching Game Show Network.
Sometimes game shows have the distinction of having several different incarnations. Sometimes they switch networks. Sometimes they can be seen in both daytime and primetime editions. Our next show can claim all of these. From Goodson Todman Productions, Beat the Clock debuted on CBS as a primetime show in March of 1950.
It was hosted by Bud Collier, who was the radio voice of Superman. Tall and dignified, Collier managed to convey an air of calm around people performing all sorts of stunts. The first version of Beat the Clock enjoyed a run of almost 11 years. In September of 1957, it started a one-year stint on CBS Daytime. When that ended, ABC picked it up for a two-and-a-half-year run in daytime. But wait, there's more. The show was brought back for syndication in September 1969, hosted by veteran MC Jack Nars. And it's interesting to note that for this version, Beat the Clock was produced in two different countries. The first season was taped at the Little Theater in New York City. And a year later, production moved to Montreal, Canada. In 1972, Gene Wood took over the hosting duties for the final 2 years. And as you probably know, Gene is currently the voice of Family Feud. Keeping with the old adage, the show must go on, CBS brought back Beat the Clock for a four-month daytime run in September 1979. The host this time was Monty Hall. This is one of the few times that Monty hosted a show he didn't actually produce. And the announcer on Monty's version was none other than former host Jack Nars. And just a reminder, you can see Beat the Clock with Bud Collier weekdays at 6:30 a.m. and with Jack Nars weekdays at 1 p.m. right here on Game Show Network. Now let's have a look at Beat the Clock with Bud Collier. It's an episode originally broadcast on July 31st, 1954.
Time for fun has now begun, let's all play Beat the Clock.
Beat the Clock is brought to you by Sylvania, a quality name in lighting, photo lamps, radio tubes, television, electronics.
Let's all play Beat the Clock.
Now here is America's number one clock watcher, Bud Collier.
Thank you. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome once again to Beat the Clock, the show where you have the time of your life playing against time for big-time prizes. Let's come over and meet our first contestants tonight, shall we? Hello.
How are you?
Fine, thank you. This is Mr. and Mrs. Robert Larson of Manchester, Connecticut. Let's have a welcome from our studio audience.
Thank you.
Oh, you can burn there even if you have a tan ahead of time, can't you? What do you do, Bob?
Aeronautical engineer at Pratt & Whitney Aircraft.
Huh? You have, you've been married how long?
Almost 2 years.
What about children?
Little baby, 3.5 months. Little girl.
What's your name?
Glenda Lee.
Ah, well, look at him grinning when you talk about it. Well, that's real nice. I guess you remember, if you watched the show last week, that those two toupees are not hanging anymore. There's a brand new one starting this time at $500, and of course it adds $100 each week. Whenever that bell rings, the new bonus will be tried by whoever's at the microphone at that time. Boy, we didn't even think that anybody was going to wear those toupees, but they did. And it was worth $3,200 when it went. Real wonderful, I tell you. All right. Let's see now, Bob. We have a little problem for the two of you here. And before we do that, Roxanne has something for you from both of us and all of us on the show. It's one of our Beat the Clock games. And you folks, you know, with your grown-up friends, this isn't for kids only. This is for grown-ups, too. There's a clock there and props to do all kinds of games. And, of course, the games were originated by the same two guys that worked with me on the show here that do the stunts. That's Frank Wayne and Bob Howard. I'm going to give you that. You can put it right down behind you there, if you will, please, Miss Larson. And it'll be ready there for you to take along with you when you go. Now, on the $100 clock, suppose you both come over here with me, and I'll show you what your problem is. You stand right over here, Miss Larson. Mr. Larson, I want to ask you to step in this little wading pool, if you don't mind, facing the audience. That's the idea. Now, when I say go, all you have to do is to stamp with your feet and break two of those balloons. That's all you have to do. Now, your job, Ms. Larson, is to keep around here, and if you have to kick one of them out, you know, or it slips away from them, grab it and put it back in. Yeah, if you find that you're running out of supplies, there's a fresh supply of balloons right behind you there. See them all? Okay, let's take a look at the clock, see how many seconds you have. You have 50 seconds. Oh, and I forgot to tell you, we're going to blindfold you. So put a blindfold on you, if you will, Madeline. That's the girl. Pull it down good and snug here so he can't see a thing. See anything?
No. Nope.
All right, Bob, you all set now? Start stamping, go. That's one.
Stay in the pool there. That's it. Keep putting them in there. Stamp away, boy. Come on. Keep stamping.
There we are. Stop the clock. Good boy. All right, come on back over here, Miss Larson, if you will, please. You got through the first one, all right?
One of the biggest fun about that thing is that you keep thinking the side of the pool is part of the balloon, you know, and you're working away on it, and it's not getting anywhere. That's right. All right, Miss Larson, that's fine. Manchester, Connecticut should be proud of you because you got through the first clock in real record time. That was, you didn't even use all the time you needed. But it's time now for some tip-top TV talk from friend Bill Shipley.
Brace yourself for the action movie that's nothing less than brilliant. The Professional is an absolute knockout. Explosive and thrilling.
I'm dying to need him.
A riveting, nail-biting film. It makes speed look like a slow ride to Grandma's house. From internationally acclaimed action director Luc Besson, The Professional, rated R, at theaters now.
Gene Rayburn remembers a match game blooper.
I was talking to this beautiful young woman, and I wanted to compliment her on the beauty of her face, and she had two lovely dimples.
Doesn't she have pretty nipples, pretty dimples there?
I was just frozen.
This lady has very pretty dimples in her cheeks, doesn't she?
I got a check from some station in London saying we used your blooper.
Get in on the fun. Watch Game Show Network.
All right, now, Mr. Larson, this next problem on the $200 clock is all for you. If you'll come over here with me, I'll show you what we have in mind. Now, here, we have a special kind of a ramp slide. You see, it goes up from this side and it slides down on the other side. Now, if you step over here, I'll show you the why and the where for that, just why it's there. I'm carrying this hat box for a very definite reason. I'm going to place this hat box halfway along the back here, which is your course of operation. You operate behind this little ramp. Now, here's the supply of saucers. You stand behind the end of this ramp, hand on the saucer, slide it up and over the top there, run around here, grab the hat box, run down to the other end, and catch the dish before it hits the ground and breaks. Got the idea? All you have to do is catch one dish. We'll stop the clock and you'll beat the clock. If you miss it, come back, drop the hat box on the way, come back here, and slide another one up. Got it? Yep. All right, let's take a look at the clock, you and I, and see how many seconds you have. You have 55 seconds. Step in front of me and I'll get out of your way. Pick up the box and catch it in the box. Are you ready? Go. Well, all right, now. You got it on the first try. Now, just for the fun of it, you got it. You've beaten the clock. Not going to take that away from you. Just for fun, see if you can do it again on the first try. Just for fun. Get that box up right there. That's it. Now, you remember, you stand right behind here, right at the back here. Slide and don't leave here until you get started. You ready? Just for fun now. Go. I'll show you the two comments a wife makes about her husband. On the balloon side, she said to me, well, he's got big feet. You didn't hear that, but that's what she said. On this one, she said, I always knew he was wonderful. There you go, from the sublime to the ridiculous. Okay, now it's your turn. Try for our jackpot clock. If you'll step back over there, Mr. Larson, you, young lady, will step up here on this little platform at the far end and turn around and face the audience. Now, don't turn back again until I tell you to. In back of you now is our jackpot board, and we've got on all the words of a famous saying or quotation. They're all mixed up and out of order. You got to move them around on the board until they spell out the correct saying correctly. Got it? 20 seconds from the time I say go, and don't look till I tell you to. Open the curtain. Turn around and take a look. Go. All right, stop the clock. There's nobody here but us kicking. 2 minutes. Give her a kick. Wow, she deserves it. I'm telling you, I never saw two people go through stunts so fast in my life. We got a whole lot of time left over here. You want to do some more stunts just for the fun of it? Well, you've beaten our jackpot clock. Let's see what you've won. Just take a look over here. This is the Stratford with exclusive halo lights around the 21-inch screen and with a great new photo power chassis. Congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. Larson. You have just won Sylvania's jackpot prize. My congratulations to you. You have two mighty good contestants. Don't forget to vote every day on the way. Goodbye. Huh. Telling you, we could have timed those stunts at 10 seconds, and they still could have done them. They were working so fast. Roxanne, who do you have now?
Right, I'd like you to meet Jerry and Mr. and Mrs. Morris Kane from Geneseo, Illinois.
Geneseo, Illinois. Geneseo, it's called. Thank you, Roxanne, and a welcome to you. Let's have a welcome from out there, too. All right. Now,
Young man, how are you?
Very nice to meet you. Come on out here a sec. Attaboy, I want to talk to you a minute. How old are you?
Seven.
And what's your name?
Jerry.
Jerry, you're tall for seven, aren't you, huh? Let's see where you come to on me here. Yeah, you're real tall. What are you going to be when you grow up, Jerry?
Scientist.
Are you? Is your daddy a scientist? How'd you make up your mind you want to be a scientist?
I saw so many dinosaur pictures in the
movie? No. On TV?
You saw some magazines.
In the magazines. You saw a lot of dinosaur pictures in the magazine, so that made you decide you want to be a scientist. Well, good boy for you. You got a book of them, have you? You never dream about dinosaurs, do you? I tell you, we have something for you here. And it's a special thing. We not only have for you one of our Beat the Clock games, thank you very much, Roxanne, but we have a Kodak Duaflex 3 camera, complete with flash gun and all these wonderful Sylvania flash bulbs with a blue dot for sure shot. See them there? How's that? Can you hold all that? Tell you what, set it down back there. You won't have to hold it there. You can take it off stage with you when you go. That'll keep you busy for a while, I hope. Well, on the $100 clock, we have a problem for you, and I think maybe you might take your glasses off of this, if you don't mind. You put them right there, and I think they'd be perfectly safe. There we are. Come on over here, if you will, and let's see how well we do on this one. Thank you very much. You, sir, you too. Oh, you come over too. Oh, yes, indeed. I'm going to ask you, if you will, please, to just lie down here on the floor with your head over that way and your feet out this way. That's right. That's the idea. Okay, now you come over here, please, and stand right up at his head, you know, sort of in back of him, a little further away. I'm going to take this stack of cereal boxes we have here, place it on your forehead, sir. I'm going to ask you to place your forehead on the other end of this stack and press good and tight so you don't lose the sack. Oh, watch it. See, you have to be very careful there. Very careful to press. You got another stack already for me? That's fine. Thank you, Madeline. Okay, here we are. Right on his forehead. You take a hold of the sack and get it adjusted until you've got it there. You got it? Now, you got to press good and tight. Press good and hard. Hold it. You got it? Okay. Now, the stunt is comparatively simple. When I say go, we simply want you to change positions without losing the sack. You stand up, you lie down, and wind up in the same position but reverse. Got it? I'll take a look at the clock. Beg pardon? Can you what?
Can I touch it?
You can't touch it with your hands at any time. Just your two foreheads, but you press good and tight. You'll find that it'll stay there. You'll also find that you can turn your head. I mean, you can turn around on these things. My suggestion to you, sir, is that you get up first before she starts to lie down. Got it? The clock says 55 seconds. Are you ready? Go. Good and hard. Good and hard. That's it. Rotate on your head. Keep the pressure up. Be careful. Keep it even. That's it. Oh! Back here. Here we go again. All right. Let's get it set here now. We'll get it straight for you. We'll get her all set here. Good and straight. Wouldn't ask you to do it crooked for the world. All right, you got it? You take a hold of it until you get the pressure just right. You got it? Okay, you ready? Go. Got the time. Just take it easy. Not too fast. Now you start to move up. You start to move up. You come up here. You come up. Counteract the body. Down. No, no. Keep the pressure up here. Keep the pressure. Keep close to it. Keep over. That's the idea. Careful. Don't push it. Don't push it. Get your feet out. That's it. Take it easy. Now you still got time to do it. You can do it. You can do it. You can do it. Your head down. Up. Okay. Now, this starts at $500 and adds $100 a week. Thank you very much, madam. We have here just a pretend full milk bottle. It's not full at all, you see. We have here a little stick. A stick about, it's about 3 feet long. Now, we want you to place the stick inside the milk bottle like that, you see? Now, I place the milk bottle on the floor here. I give you the end of the string, which is tied to the middle of the stick, and I place it on the floor in front of the milk bottle. Here you are, sir. You must hold it by one finger through that loop like that. Got the idea? And get either end of it in the bottle. We'll stop the clock. You'll beat the clock for $500 on the new bonus. The clock says how many seconds? 40 seconds. Beg pardon?
Can I touch my body with this?
No, you're supposed to keep it free of your body entirely. Are you ready? Go. didn't beat the clock on the new bonus. $100 next week, that'll be worth. Get the dowel in the milk bottle. All right, it was a good try. That's only a bonus, you know.
Only a bonus, $500 worth.
But in any event, it doesn't stop you going right on to the next clock. So that's what I mean when we call it a bonus. It's just sort of an added attraction is what we have. And that last one last week, boy, oh, boy, I'm telling you, $3,200. A Baptist minister from Virginia and his family, they won it. Did you see it? Did you? It was really exciting, wasn't it? All right, well, we're going to find out our next problem for you right off the bat if you're not getting too warm doing them all. But before we get into the technique of the next one, right now let's see how many of these questions about television you can answer. Ask them, Bill Shipley.
All right, in just a moment, I'm going to tell you how you can register to play Decades. But right now, let's find out if Mike Wagner can beat the clock with his explanation of the eligibility requirements. Go ahead, Mike, beat the clock.
No purchase necessary. All entrants must have pre-registered and have a valid PIN number. Winners must sign an affidavit of eligibility. Contests open to all legal residents of the United States 18 years of age and older, except employees and their families of Sony Pictures Entertainment, Game Show Network, and any other person or entity associated with contests. Void were prohibited by law. Subject to all applicable laws and regulations. Taxes, including applicable sales tax, are the sole responsibility of winners, and contestants can win only one prize during a 30-day period. Rules may be subject to change. Odds of winning determined by number of entrants. Prizes may not be substituted or transferred. For complete rules and or a list of prize winners, send a self-addressed stamped envelope to Game Show Network Rules, P.O. Box 4312, Hollywood, California, 90078.
Yo, Mike, I think you beat the clock. All right, folks, if you want to now play the only free live interactive game in the universe, you come to the right place. Here's the phone number, 800-537-GAME, 800-537-GAME. You want to call that to get your 8-digit PIN number. You need that in order to play. And once you get it, you can play again and again and again. 800-537-GAME, touch-tone phones only, folks. That one call at 800-537-GAME will be worth fun and prizes. Right now, back to beat the clock.
He has friends wherever he goes.
Not here.
Mania.
No Goofy. No Minnie. No Mercy. Mickey Mania from Sony Imagesoft for Genesis, Sega CD, and Super Nintendo. Game systems sold separately. Also, look for Mickey Mania game tips in specially marked boxes of Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
Well, now, let's see. We're waiting for your mom and dad to get... Oh, here they say, look at the lovely shoes we put on your mother. Aren't they lovely? Oh, they are beautiful. And your father should be out here any second now, too. There he comes. All right, not going to keep you dressed up like that too long. How kids at parties love to break balloons. Well, we're going to let you break a balloon. Just for the sheer heck of it, just break a balloon. Now, if you both come over here with me, I'll show you what it is. Let's see now. Young man, would you like to come over here, too, and watch a little closer? You come on over and stand with me, will you? Bring out our balloon-breaking little emporium there. That's the idea. This is going to be real easy for you, sir, because all you have to do, Mr. Kane, is lie down. You just stretch out right there with your head on that pillow on your back and put the shower cap on before you do. And, Mr. Kane, you'll step up around back there over there where Betty is. See, she's waiting for you. You'll find out in a minute why we have done what we have about those galoshes on your feet. All right. Now, you get nice and comfortable. They're going to give you these two little strings that are fastened on a little handle. Take that one in that hand, this one in this hand, and you have two also. Now, these strings, as you notice, are attached to the four corners of this little metal plate here, you see, which has a dowel in the center, and on the end of the dowel is a needle. Up above this whole contraption is a balloon. All you have to do is by pulling. Pull on those things. You'll see what happens. You pull too, sir. Very carefully. Carefully. And straighten it up by pulling yours. No, straight. See? If you're very careful, you have to pull yours a little harder than his to keep it straight, you see. Now, that's enough. That's far enough. Because what you do is bring it up here close enough to break that balloon. Got the idea? That's all you have to do. All right, let's put it back down there and take a look and see how many seconds you have to do it. 50 seconds, and to make it much more fascinating, we're going to fill that pan full of pancake batter. So, come on, Betty, that's the idea. Pour it full. There's one. Right up to the brimming edge. That's fine. Okay, Betty, good. All right, now be very careful, because we don't want any to get on your husband, you understand? All right, are you ready? Break that balloon. Go! Gotta get a refill, girls. Bring on a refill. You can't what? Can't see? Well, just keep pulling on these things and she'll help you. Here you are. Here, wait a minute. Take the handles here. Got the handles? All right. Are you ready? Go. Now go slowly. Slowly. Pull your side. Pull your side. Pull it. Pull it. Get it. Oh, no. Pull your side. Take a picture of Mr. Kane while he's lying prone there. We'll get him all cleaned up. There we are. The girls will get him cleaned up. Take him right off, if you will. Okay, now we have taken a picture with another one of these Kodak DualFlex cameras, with another one of our Sylvania bugs with a blue dot for sure shot. And the first picture on that reel will be that of your husband lying there with what you did to him. So you have that when you get it developed. You can set that here right now, because now you have to carry on for the family and try our jackpot clock. You'll step right up here, Miss Kane. On the board, turn around and face the audience. Sorry to keep those galoshes on you like that. And back of you now is our jackpot board, and we put another saying up there, and again, we've mixed the words all up. You get them unmixed in 20 seconds, and don't look till I say so, please. Open the curtain. Turn around, take a look. Go. All right, stop the clock. All right, this is tight. All right, come on back out here, Miss Kane. Hurry, come on out here and stand alongside your mom. Because she, all by herself right now, has just beaten our jackpot clock. So let's see what you've won. Just take a look over here.
It's the 21-inch Brookfield with halo lights and such other exclusive features as photo power stretchers. Congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. Kane. You have just won Sylvania's jackpot prize.
My congratulations to you, too. You're out of the country. Find your house and sound backstage. Bye, Tom. Oh, my, oh, my. Roxanne, whom do we have now?
She's a beautiful little girl. Janet, I'd like you to meet Bud.
Hello, Janet.
Hello.
How are you?
Fine.
Good. Who have you got with her parents here?
Mr. and Mrs. Donald Nutt from Norristown, Pennsylvania.
Thank you very much, Roxanne. Hello, Miss Nutt. How are you? And let's have a welcome from out yonder. How are you? Nice to have you. Well, now, let's see. Your name is Janet?
Yeah.
That's an awful pretty dress you have, Janet. Is that new?
Yeah.
Hmm? Turn around and let everybody see the back of it, too. Why, just as pretty as it can be. How old are you now?
Seven.
You're seven. You have any brothers or sisters?
No.
Uh-huh. Well, you live in Norristown, Pennsylvania. You like it there better than you do here in New York?
Not too much.
You like New York, do you? Find it pretty exciting when you come here on a visit. Well, we have a camera for you and also one of our Beat the Clock games. There you are. Beat the Clock game for you and a DuoFlex 3 camera made by Kodak, of course. And, of course, all those wonderful Sylvania flashbulbs with a blue dot for sure shot. Can you manage that? Can you? You set it down right over there, too, honey, so you don't have to stand there and hold it. Right on that little platform there. It won't be in the way. Okay, now, Mr. Nutt, you do what, sir?
I'm a civil engineer for the Navy.
A civil engineer for the Navy. Have you always done this sort of work?
Well, most all the time.
You have. All right. How long married, Miss Nutt?
13 years.
13 years. Okay, we have a $100 clock problem for you. If you will come over here with me, I'll show you what it is. Thank you very much, Madeline. Now, here we have piece of string on just an ordinary paper cup. You sometimes get a double chocolate molded in one of these, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Now, all I want you to do, we'll start it down like that. When I say go, in the allotted amount of time, I want you to get it standing up like that. That's all you have to do. See? Okay? Take a look at the clock. See how many seconds you have. 55 seconds. I forgot to tell you that you can't use your hands. You have to hold the end of that string in your teeth.
Oh.
Okay? All right. Are you ready? Go. If you heard your little girl there, but she kept saying, well, do it, do it. Not as easy as it looks, though, is it, when you start? But then, if you calm down, you can usually do it. Well, I got you through the $100 class. You didn't have to lift a finger over there. You see, Mr. Nutt, we kind of, on this hot night, let you just kind of relax. Right now, let's try some, night driving as we take to the highway with driver Bill Shipley.
All right, gang, registration is finito, over, complete, and gone, off, and calling. No more calls, please, but you can call in later tonight and tomorrow morning to play more of Decades. And we're going to show you how to play Decades in a little bit of time. But you want to hang with us because fun and prizes. So we'll be back.
Brace yourself for the action movie that's nothing less than brilliant. The Professional is an absolute knockout. Explosive and thrilling.
I'm dying to meet him.
A riveting, nail-biting film. It makes speed look like a slow ride to Grandma's house. From internationally acclaimed action director Luc Besson, The Professional, rated R, at theaters now.
Game shows, everyone's favorite television.
These shows are so incredible. There's so much energy.
It's just so cool.
What a show!
You jump when they jump, and you laugh when they do something stupid.
I love watching the old celebrities like Ginger Rogers, Jerry Lewis. She's hilarious.
Elizabeth Taylor, she's a beautiful woman.
I can help to tell you.
Bob Hope, Groucho Marx.
What'd you say?
I can watch them all night long.
Tune in to watch, play, and win on the all-new Game Show Network.
Home video from Sony Wonder. Experience the wonder of Snow White, the classic fairy tale families can enjoy again and again. There's magic, romance, and new music that will have your children singing along.
We love our job. We know there's nothing greater.
Look for over $17 worth of savings from Johnson & Johnson and Mattel inside every video. Snow White, now on home video from Sony Wonder. Experience the wonder.
Ah, Mr. Miz, not having gotten through the $100 clock, let's try the $200 clock. Would you mind taking your glasses off, sir? Why don't you put them in your pocket where they'd be perfectly safe? If you both come over here with me, I'll show you what your problem is. All right, stand right in back of these two tables, if you will. You notice we have two tables here, and on one of them are volleyballs, on the other are basketballs. See? Volleyballs over there, basketballs over here. Now, I'm going to separate these two tables. I'm going to put this table right about here, and I'm going to leave this table right about where it is. Now, I want you, if you will, please, to stand right next to that table, and you stand next to this table. Now, when I say go, what I want you two to do is this. I want you to pick up one of these volleyballs and come over here and exchange it for one of the basketballs. You see? Mm-hmm. And then you keep exchanging volleyball for basketball until you've got all the basketballs over here, you've got all the volleyballs over there. Got the idea? One thing is involved in it, though. You must put your left hand behind your back and keep it there at all times. You can only use one hand. You got the idea? What did you say to me beside that?
We'll be blindfolded.
You'll be blindfolded. How did you guess? You will be blindfolded. That's right. I'm sorry, Betty. All right, blindfold them both, if you will, please, while I look at the clock and tell you how many seconds you have. You have 55 seconds from the time I say go. Keep that left hand behind your back at all times. Are you ready? Go. They didn't understand. Set it back again. You must exchange with each other in mid-flight, so to speak. You see? You must change, right? That's right. That's right. Okay, you want to try it again now? We put the clock back again. In other words, you reverse, and you put yours over here, and he puts those, and he gets from you over there. You move toward each other. That's all. Back and forth. Okay, you ready? Go. Put the hand behind the back. Careful. All right, there's one. There's two. One more to go now. One more to go. You find it. There it is. Come on. Don't drop it. Don't drop it. Keep that other hand behind your back. Don't drop it now. You got your arms linked. You got to get out. Come on, the edge. Oh, stop the clock. Hold it. Hold it. Stop the clock. Put this last one back. The last one back because she dropped it. All right. One more to exchange now. Oh, and I exchanged it wrong. I'm sorry. Okay. All right. Here we are,
right here. Are you ready? Go. Big change. Careful now. Put that hand behind your back. Pass. Okay. Come on back over here, if you will. Good enough. That was fine. Okay.
Well, that took some fumbling. It's kind of funny when you get your arms linked there and you couldn't get out of it for a minute. Well, they did all right, didn't they? Sure did. All right, now Mom's going to carry on for the family again. If you will step over there with Daddy, stand right down over there. Mom's got to step up on the platform here at the far end. That's it. Turn around and face the audience and don't turn back till I tell you to, because you're now in front of our jackpot board. And again, we put another saying, and again, we mixed it all up. You have 20 seconds to get it unmixed. Okay, now, don't look till I say, please. Open the curtain. Turn around, take a look. Go. United we stand, divided we fall. You did it. To be our jackpot. I think she's earned the kiss, don't you? Give her one. All right, you folks have now beaten our jackpot. How do you feel about that now, huh?
Fine.
Pretty exciting, huh? Yeah. Would you like to see what you've won?
Okay.
You would? Well, just take a look with me right over here.
Here is the 21-inch Brookfield with halo lights and such other exclusive features as Photo Power chassis. Congratulations to you, too, Mr. and Mrs. Nutt. You have just won Sylvania's jackpot prize.
Nice to have you here with us tonight. You're welcome to sports. Good night, honey. Pick up the game stuff on the way. All right. Come on, Roxanne. Let's see whom we have now, huh? Warm night, and I got you running back and forth there, haven't I?
Bud, this is Mr. and Mrs. David Danbury from Lambertville, New Jersey.
Thank you very much, Mr. and Mrs. Danbury. A welcome to you, and a welcome from everybody out on this hot night right there. How are you? Now, let's see, what do you do, Mr. Danbury?
Farmer.
You're a farmer. Well, on the farm sometimes, when you're not feeding the cows and the chickens, here's one of our beat-the-clock games. You want to put it right back there, Mr. Danbury? You've been married 10 years, according to your card, and you have two children. Is that right? Okay, on the $100 clock, come on over. Oh, you're not even going to find out what it is. That time has run out. Can you come back next week?
You can.
All right, you'll be our first contestant, then, and I wish you the best of luck at that time. Now, ladies and gentlemen, when I say I wish them the best of luck, I do, because I'll be gone for 4 weeks. I'm going to take off with my family and have a little vacation, and my good friend Bob Kennedy is going to be carrying on here. The clock will be ticking away just as usual. The new bonus will be running at $100 a week extra, and I hope you'll all be with us and still be here when I return. I'll be seeing you in 4 weeks, and until then, this is Bud Collier speaking for Sylvania, hoping that next time may be your time to beat the clock. Good night, everybody.
This has been a Mark Goodson, Bill Godman production, produced in association with the CBS Television Network.
You're watching Game Show Network.